Greetings all, it's the Devious Monkey here. It's been an interesting couple of days as far as testing goes. Yesterday I posted two videos, one to rant about the Weeble 2 and what I perceived as its inability to work correctly when you're in 4K on the Sony A7C. Then, fortunately, somebody, Yankee Cowboy, came in and pointed out something that might work, and in fact, it did. I had to change the HDMI settings to auto. And once I did that, boom, everything fell into place. So I was able to film on the A7C while I had it connected to the Weeble 2 and the Transmitter AI, and everything turned out just peachy. So I'm back to shooting in 4K today, just because I wanted to play around with certain things, one of them being my Insta360 ONE R with the 4K module. There was a firmware upgrade that I found out about. So I ran it the other day, and then yesterday I took it out and I started filming with it, and I found that the audio was completely unusable. This felt and picked up every bump and jar and turn in my Forerunner that happened the entire time I was filming. And it had never done that before. It was never that bad. And I seem to recall it, you know, not being an issue. Now, granted, I knew that the audio wasn't that great, but it also wasn't that bad. So I decided, okay, today I'm going to shoot by connecting the Rode Wireless Go 2 to the setup like I did before with the little audio adapter that goes into the USB-C plug. And I thought, all right, that should eliminate all the problems because now it's all coming from here, not the actual unit itself. Wrong. It was even worse today than it was yesterday when I was using the audio. Now, I'm gonna have to go in and look at the settings just to make sure that it's not, didn't override this and started using and continue to use the internal microphone, because that doesn't make any sense to me that it would pick up the noise from the bumps of the Forerunner when I had it connected to this. Now, this is the Rode Wireless Go 1, not the 2, but you get the point, same thing. It shouldn't have picked up all that noise. I mean, it was horrible. So I'm gonna go play around with the settings, but basically I'm getting rid of all of that footage because, I mean, it sucks. So I decided to film this instead. A couple of things that I went out to do today when I got up. I was running around here trying to remember all the shit that I keep forgetting. You know, like I told you, I gotta go to Target at least once a day, every day, because I forget so many things. But I kind of had it all down, and I think I got it to the point where I'm like, okay, I think I know what I need to do. So first thing I did after I cleaned up around here and got myself sort of situated was that I was going to go have breakfast. But also, let me back up a little bit, I did end up ordering the CBD gummy bears that I had gotten, I don't know, a little over a year ago, maybe even longer than that, who knows, time just flies by. And they were the only ones that I had ever used, the only product, period, that I've ever used that instantly made me feel better. I got them at the UPS store, I chewed on one, I drove 10 minutes to the state park, and by the time I got out of my car, I already felt the difference. And I was shocked that it was so amazing, and I was like, oh, finally. You know, I found something that just, I could just feel everything in me relax, and I was less road ragey and annoyed and all that kind of stuff. And I thought, okay, this is great. Until about 5 days later, and I got the shits. And I basically thought that I crapped out my internal organs because I just couldn't stop. And I thought, okay, what the hell? The only thing I did was to get these gummy bears. After some research, I found out that it was the, I think it's MCT oil in it, slash coconut oil. You know, everything gets a different name, but it all comes down to, I think, coconut oil. And I couldn't find a product that didn't have that in it. And if I did find a product that didn't specifically list that type of oil, it didn't do shit for me. So these gummy bears, again, were the only things that ever made me feel good. After 20 plus years of constant pain, the only product that made me feel good, with the side effect of crapping out my internal organs. So I just couldn't deal with that, not with being on the road all the time. So I thought to myself, you know what, let me see if I can regulate this and figure out a way to not necessarily counteract that, but make it less horrible. And I'm gonna be figuring that out over the next few weeks. Wish me luck. Okay, so anyway, so this morning I got up, got my shit all together, cleaned up around the house, tried to get myself all situated to know what it was that I had to do. And I took a gummy And then I went to breakfast. So I went to have breakfast at this place that I haven't been to for a long time. Enjoyed my breakfast. Was watching Archer while I was sitting there. You know, just a good, easy plug into the morning. And I didn't realize until just recently when I started thinking about it how I instantly feel great again. So that gummy, man, those things are amazing. I'll link it down in the description if you're interested. Just be careful. You might have to crap out your internal organs if you take it, if you don't adjust well with that coconut oil. But okay, enough about pooping. After I did that, I had to go to the mall to get a present. And then I was deciding that, you know, I've got $75 worth of gift cards for the Apple store. So I went to the Apple store and kind of looked around and decided there wasn't really anything that I needed to get. And I don't want to just buy something for the sake of buying something unless I actually need it. So put that off. And then I went to Home Depot to find light bulbs for the Christmas tree up here, the ceramic Christmas tree. It's not that the bulb went out. It's that yesterday when I lifted it up while it was on, I damn near burned my fingertips off. Man, did that thing get hot, because it had a normal old-fashioned bulb inside of it. And I was like, holy shit, you know, that scared the crap out of me that it got that hot. So I shut it off and then eventually went to, you know, pulled it apart and took the bulb out. And the weird thing was that it was one of those like decorative bulbs, but it had a big normal sized base, not the skinny one that usually goes with those decorative bulbs. You know, the ones that are sort of shaped like a flame. So I was like, okay, well, I'll just go to Home Depot tomorrow and I'll get a bulb. I went to Home Depot and there were like a freaking million light bulbs all over the place. It took me a while to figure out how to go through and find exactly what I needed. And of course, like a dumb monkey, I forgot to take the one with me. So I could figure out how big the hole was that it had to go up inside. Giggity. I thought, okay, well, I'll just use this one. Blah, 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 blah. I ended up finding a damn bulb. So I got a triple pack of those LED decorative bulbs, whatever, with a normal size base, and came back in and put it in, and it fit perfectly. Everything, you know, the tree went back on, and obviously it lit up the bulbs and everything. And I've had it going for about a half an hour now, and there's no heat whatsoever. That's the amazingness of LED bulbs. So now I feel much better that I don't have that, you know, old fashioned incandescent freaking flame throwing light bulb in there to burn my freaking studio down. That mission was accomplished. So I got a lot accomplished today. There's not really a lot of day job work because Wednesday technically was the deadline. And if anybody even bothered to pay attention to it, they would know that Wednesday was the deadline, even though the deadline was extended to today. But at this point, if they haven't, you know, answered me now, it's too damn late. So I'm just not going to worry about it. And the next couple of weeks, I'm just going to sort of go with the flow, do my visits, enjoy driving around and seeing some sights and getting some film, and sort of ease into the year. And then I have the last week of the year off, and it's the first time in years that I've actually officially taken a vacation. So I took the entire last week of December off, and I'm not doing jack shit. So that'll be time for me to play with anything that I get over Christmas and continue to play with what I have and just enjoy myself. I didn't realize I had a call at 3:00. So in like 10 minutes, I've got a freaking work call that should hopefully go pretty quick. So yeah, things are going pretty good. I need to eat lunch as well. I haven't done that yet, and it's already going on 3. So yeah, all right. Typical day in my life. Just complete, like, All right, so that's pretty much all I've got for you today. There's no point in me rambling on, you know, but I guess that's what I do. That's what my vlogs are. They're my daily blathering on. Hopefully you don't get too bored with it. That's all I got. If you have any comments, questions, or suggestions, leave them down below. As always, thank you for joining me. Be sure to like and subscribe. And remember, kids, forward and up.